Okay, let me ask you a question. What motivates you when you wake up in the morning and you know you have to face the Chennai traffic up there? What do you do? Do you have a cup of tea? Do you have a big hug from someone? Do you listen to the radio? Or maybe it's your work that puts you out there, gets you through the day. What's that little spark? Now, I'll share with you a quote. Oops. Okay, what's done in love is done where? Okay, now when I was 3 years old, I wanted to be an archaeologist, okay? I found all the mythology, all the stories about ancient times. I found them interesting, even things like this. I wanted to discover, and you know one thing about this is that apart from the age that's there, each artifact you find has a story, okay? Now that story, it adds to the value of that artifact. And I found that inspiring. But then I realized they're probably not in the mood, and so bones to find, or I don't want skeletons. So I started reading about someone called Gaudi. Now Gaudi she was an architect, a Spanish architect. And I came across this quote. He said that light is the mother of all positive forms, but architecture is the measure and the distribution of that light. Now what happened when I read about this is that she widened my understanding of what architecture was. At first architecture was just design. But what she said, you can put physics, you can put maths, you can put biology, you can put them all together and incorporate them into your design. Make something new. Okay. Now I try to experiment that over here and try it. And a few of my works, conceptual works. One of them was to experiment with forms, right? So I tried to make an apple for personal space where you can carve your way through and create a comfortable environment for yourself. That is one thing. Shaped like an apple. The next concept is for school. And I thought of children. They like to be in place where they like to have fun. Yeah. So one thing was possibly tree houses. So that is my second concept. These are the ideas. Okay. So now, as an architecture student, there are hurdles, obviously. But there were two mighty big hurdles. Okay, that was the dissertation and thesis. Okay, so dissertation, all right. There's so many. The challenge is that you have to put so many words together, come up with something that either tells you something or somebody else. It can helps to see it in different ways. According to your research, you find a way out of that. I found that hard, but let's see what I got. My dissertation was called Ancient Strength, which is probably not a surprise. Ancients? Okay. Now what strength? Okay, wait. First, why did they pick our ancient strength? Was because these ancient monuments, I want to understand. They've been here since then. The pyramids, the Stonehenge, how did they stand the test of time? They didn't have half of the materials we use. The new industries didn't have half of the technology. They did it by hand most of the time. So now what's strength? By Oxford Dictionary. Yeah, it's the quality or state of being physically strong, obviously. How to withstand substance and withstand great forces of power, right? And this is physical strength. Another kind of strength is your inner strength. Okay, what the building can show. Now I experimented on three buildings, yeah. I'll summarize them. I'm choosing one, which is the pyramids. Okay, now the pyramids, they have lots of stories within them. But I wasn't able to find out that strength that made it stand. There was one empty bank in between, and I was trying to research. I was reading these big books that you can sleep from, like, okay. But then I figured out one thing. Okay, now they use these big blocks of limestone, they bagged it to make the pyramids. What about those limestone? If you look back, this to her. It is not a desert completely. It also had, it was a savanna. It had water before. But because of climate change, it became the heat. Yeah, all the water dried up. All that water was absorbed into the limestones. And as a result, those limestones had high water content. Also, interestingly, inside the limestone, there were tiny shells called pneumoite. Okay, these were fossils. They were like very, very small throughout that limestone. Now, if you think architecturally, you have water, you have limestone, and you have tiny fissures that act as an aggregate. What do you get? In our perspective, we get something called concrete. Today, concrete is the strongest building material. I don't know if they knew that, but they used it. And when I found that about that, it was my eureka moment. Okay, the thing is that, the point of this is that, from A, when you get the proposal for the design, to B, when you have a final design, there's so many hurdles, so many problems in between. But what got me from A to B, my love for the subject, and at B, you know, when you look back, all that effort was worth it. Because at that moment, you feel satisfied. You feel happy. Okay? That's what it is for me. Now, architecture, you experiment with forms, right? And you can even experiment with space. Now, forms and space, what else can you do with those two? You can express yourself. Another way of doing that is through music and dance. Okay. So now, okay, music, or should I say, silent music, what's that, it's a paradox, maybe, I'll tell you, wait, now, okay, imagine, your ears are completely blocked, okay, now, the sense that works the most is the eyesight, right? So now, if you look around, okay, your eyesight, it can look at small clues around you and picks those clues up, okay. For example, one of my friends, I was studying in an empty classroom in front of a whiteboard, I was drawing. She comes behind me, she's tiptoeing really quietly because she wants to scare me. But I turn around, she's like, what? How did you know I was coming from behind you? Dude, I... Actually, if you watch spy movies, you know this. Throughout, everywhere, actually, things affect. There's a reflection somewhere. For me, it was the whiteboard. And there was a lot of sunlight. So, due to the reflection, I saw her shadow coming, and I turned. So now you notice these small things, and the basic thing, you notice the movement. Now I see a classroom, and sorry, I see actual her, and everybody here. It's not really moving. So I understand, it's quiet. But if somebody at the back was to get up and start thumping around, I know he's making some noise because they see him. You can associate movement with the sound, okay? So now going on, if you watch this.
Move it, I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to move it.
Okay, you know the song now. So now, basically, when you picture the sound of the song, the song what is not good silence it. But if you put what you have in the memory of that sound, I like to move it, and you see the specialization, you see that the circle expands with each word. I like to move it, I like to move it, okay? So now, even if it's shut off, you can visualize it in your head, the song. All right, thank you. Okay, now the point of that is that you have a memory of the sound and you visualize. Let me simplify this sound out for you. Say I have a pin, right? The pin is on the table and I start hitting the pin on two metals, see? You know that sound stinky, right? Now if I start thumping on the table, you know that sound too? It's like a thump. You can associate it with words. So now when you see someone playing on the drums, you know that's metal. And this one makes more of a bass sound, right? So you can visualize the different kinds of sounds, different kinds of beats according to movements. Put those together and you get the music. You can get different kinds of waves of that music also. So now using these basic movements and as well as counting, I understood how you dance. Like when she was doing that, you all understood it, yeah? What was going on in my mind was 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2. That is what's going on in my head, and that's how I created music. Now, what is the point of all this? I think, for those of you who haven't figured this out yet, yes, I can't hear. But how did I get to the bottom of all this? How do I still love music? That's the thing, to love. That love brought me all this way to continue my drawing what I love the most. Okay. So now, there was love for music, there was love for life, because I didn't want to put myself down. It's all right. They can produce their problem. Okay? The third thing though, they got me through this. The people who loved me too. My family. My friends. Now all of them. Each moment of my life because of their love for me and my love for them too. We've gone through different hurdles across life. So now I talk about all of this. The things you do according to love. I drank it with a cup of tea. But I act, when you drink tea, you feel motivated. You feel inspired, right? And I think each day you should have at least one cup of tea so that you do something you love and it stops you going forward. Okay? Now I'll ask you one question.